In the previous video, there was a question regarding the number of possible isomers of the formula C4H9Br. Now there, the similar nature of methyl dioxine isobutene was shown by a model. Now, when you take the touching points of these methyl groups on the paper, we get an equilateral triangle whose corners are occupied by methyl groups. Then there can be a mirror plane like this, a mirror placed here, this methyl and this methyl become images. Another mirror placed here, this methyl and this methyl become images. A mirror placed here, this methyl and this methyl become images. So all the methyl groups are similarly placed, or we say they are equivalent. So without model, we can come to the conclusion that these methyls are equivalent by drawing such a picture. Now coming to the branch of compounds containing hydroxy group. The aliphatic hydroxy compounds are called alcohols, and aromatic hydroxy compounds are called phenols. Now the IUPAC naming of alcohols. The longest carbon chain containing the carbon connected to the OH group is selected and numbered. And the numbering is done in such a way that the carbon atom to which OH group is connected possesses the least possible number. So that is the IUPAC rule. Now the parent hydrocarbon is that hydrocarbon containing the number of carbon atoms in the longest chains. So suppose the longest chain contains 5 carbon atoms, the parent carbon atom is that hydrocarbon containing 5 carbon atoms. That is, if it is a saturated compound, then the parent is pentane. Now the locating number, that is the number of that carbon to which the OH is connected, or a branch is connected, a methyl group or ethyl group is connected, that is called locating number. The locating number is written first, and then the name of the group or branch, and then lastly the name of the parent hydrocarbon without the last letter E. If it is pentane, then the last letter E is avoided, and we write it as pendan. Then you give the locating number of the alcoholic group, OH group, and then the suffix OL for alcohol, OL, OL is written. Now an example. Here the numbering is done in this manner, from left hand side to right hand side, because the carbon to which OH is connected get the least possible number, that is 2. If it was from here, 1, 2, 3, the locating number would have 3. So we select numbering in this manner from left hand side to right hand side. Now the parent contains 4 carbon atoms, that is butane. Locating number of OH group is 2. Then the name is butan 2-ol. So simple. If there are branches or alkyl groups, the locating number or numbers are written first, and the names of branch or branches are followed. For example, this compound, the parent compound, the longest carbon chain containing the OH group is this one, 1, 2, 3, that is propane. So parent is propane. And on second carbon, there is a branch, that is methyl. So write first the locating number of the branch, that is 2. Name of branch, that is methyl. then parent hydrocarbon without the last letter E, that is propan, and the locating number of the OH group, that is 1. So it is 2-methylpropan-1-ol. Now coming to some questions from the exercise. Now this compound is given. You start numbering from this point or from this point. But we have to select that carbon chain containing the OH group. So we cannot number from this point because this carbon chain does not contain the OH group. So select that carbon chain which possesses the carbon atom connected to the OH group. So we have to number from this carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then this becomes a branch. Now this branch is numbered 1 dash and 2 dash, that is the carbon directly bonded to the main chain is numbered 1 dash because 1 is here, so 1 dash is written, then 2 dash, and on 1 dash there is a CH3 group, a methyl group, and 1 dash 2 dash indicates that the parent hydrocarbon group is ethyl group. So on ethyl group we replace 1 hydrogen by a CH3, that is the supposition. Now here on carbon 3 we have a chlorine connected to methyl, and this group as a whole is called chloromethyl group. Now we can name this compound. It is 3 chloromethyl. Then it is 1-ol. On 2 there is a branch 2, within brackets you write 1-methyl, then the parent alkyl group is ethyl, within brackets you write it, and then the carbon number is 5, the longest chain carbon number is 5, so the parent is pentane. So you write pentane 1-ol. So pentane a hyphen then 1-ol. So that is the correct naming, but in the text it is said that this is isopropyl group, so 2-isopropyl it is written, but the correct naming should be, according to UPSC, should be 1-methyl-ethyl. Anyway, even if you write it as propyl, there is no harm. So that is one example. Now then another example, this compound. Now one speciality of this compound is that CH3CH CH3CHOH C CH3 CH3 CH3. So the longest carbon chain containing the OH group should be, we can start from this carbon or all our equivalent carbon atoms. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If we start from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then both are the same because the third carbon is connected to the OH group. But if we number from this end, then the methyl carbon gets the lowest locating number. And if we number from this direction, the carbon to which OH is connected is 3, and if we number from this direction, again the carbon to which OH is connected is 3. So to prefer a lowest locating number, we have to number from this end, so that 1 is here, 2 here, 3 here, 4 here, and 5 here. But another difficulty with this numbering is that when we number from this point on carbon 2, there are two methyl groups. So numbering from this direction will give numbering from this direction, that is 1 here, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We get 2,2-dimethyl, then 4-methyl, that is 2,2,4-trimethyl, pentane 3-ol. So the locating numbers are 2, 2, 4. And if we number from this direction, it is 2, 4, 4. So numbering from this direction, 2, 3, 4. And on carbon 4, we have 2 methyl groups. So it is 2,4,4-trimethyl. But 2,2,4 is a set of lowest locating numbers than 2,4,4. So you forget this one and the number from this direction 1,2,3,4,5. So this numbering is not accepted, because we get a set of locating numbers 2,4,4, whereas here we get 2,2,4. So lowest locating numbers are possible here. So we start numbering from this carbon 1,2. On carbon 2 there are 2 methyl groups, so 2,2. Then on carbon 4 there is a methyl group, 2,2,4. Trimethyl, then pentane is the parent hydrocarbon. Then on 3 there is OH group. And when we number from this direction or this direction, the OH group is connected to carbon 3. So that is the name of the compound, 2,2,4 trimethyl pentane 3-ol. Now a third example. On second carbon there is OH, on fourth carbon there is OH, on fifth carbon there is ethyl, and this is also ethyl. So when you split this group into CH2, CH3, we get the same group as here. So we can number from this end or from this end, and when we are numbering from this end, the locating numbers of OH groups are 2 and 4. So it is 5-ethyl heptane, 7 carbon atoms, heptane, 2,4-diol. Then this compound, very simple, 1,2,3, that is propane, is the parent compound. So propane, 1,2,3-triol. Now in this compound, we have to split this C2H5 group into CH2 and CH3, and then it comes 1,2,3,4,5, including the C2H5 group, so that it is 2-ol, and the parent is pentane. So pentane 2-ol, or we can call it pent 2-ol also, either pentane 2-ol or pentadual, better you prefer pentadual. And there is a methyl dipentate carbon, so it is 3-methyl-pentan-2-ol. Now there is a question, that is, write the structure of 2-methyl-butan-2-ol. Now it is somewhat difficult to name a compound from its structure, but it is easy, quite easy to write the structure of a compound from its name. For example, here 2-methyl-butan-2-ol, we find the parent is butane, so you write 4 carbon atoms in a chain and number it from any direction here, or here we can start 1, 2, 3, 4. Then on carbon 2 you connect the methyl group, again it is 2 also, you connect the OH group on carbon 2, so we get the structure. So it is easy to write the structure from the name. You write the number of carbon atoms as in the parent and number it first from any direction and then connect groups according to the locating numbers. Then 1-phenyl-propan-2-ol, you write 3 carbon atoms, the parent is propane, and then number it from any direction, say 1, 2, 3 from the left hand side, and on carbon 1 you connect the phenyl group, on carbon you connect the OH group, the remaining valences of carbon are satisfied by hydrogen atom. Now another question, draw the structures of isomeric alcohols of molecular formula C5H12O. Now C5H12O may be written as C5H11OH because it is an alcohol. Then the valency of OH and H are equal, that is 1. So you replace the OH group by one hydrogen group, you get C5H11 plus H, that is C5H12. So C5H12, that is N-pentane is the parent hydrocarbon, where N equals 5, and it agrees with the general formula CnH2n plus 2. Now to draw the isomeric structures, first of all you draw 5 carbon atoms in a chain, then place a mirror at the middle carbon. Now these 2 carbons form object and image, so they are marked by into signs, and these 2 carbons form object and image, so they are marked by tick sign, and this carbon is unique, so there are, we can say, 3 different types of carbons. So we can have 3 different monohydric or alcohols from this structure. Now you connect OH group to the first carbon, then it is 1-pentanol or a pentan-1-ol, numbering the carbon chain. Then you connect the OH group to the second carbon, then you name it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so it is pentan-2-ol. Now the speciality of pentan-2-ol is that this carbon is connected to OH, CH3H, and this is propyl group, so all 4 groups are different. So this compound is optically active, so it can have its image structure also enantiomer. So from this one we can have 2 structures, so 1 then plus 2, total 3 structures. Then again we can have this carbon as a different carbon having different environment, so a third structure is possible, that is pentan-3-ol. So altogether 2 plus 1 plus 1, that is 4 structures when you draw the carbon atoms, 5 carbon atoms in a chain. Now you write 4 carbon atoms in a chain, then you place a mirror here. These two carbons are similarly placed or equivalent. These two carbons are equivalent. So the fifth carbon may be connected to these two carbons. We get when fifth carbon is connected to this carbon or this carbon, the same isomer is formed. But when you connect the fifth carbon to the end carbons, we get this structure, that is the state change structure having five carbon atoms, so that the end carbon atoms are avoided. And since these two carbons are similar, equivalent, we can connect the fifth carbon here or a fifth carbon here, we get the same isomer. And this structure in which the fifth carbon is connected to the middle, the second or third carbon, is this one. Now this carbon structure has got a mirror plane where these two carbons form object and images. So these two carbons are equivalent, we say. Then this carbon is different, this carbon is different, and this carbon is different. So we have a set of four different carbons having different environments, so that OH group may be connected to this carbon, this carbon, this carbon, and this carbon. Then four isomers are possible. When OH is connected to this carbon and remaining valences are connected to hydrogen, we get 1, 2, 3, 4, that is 3-methyl-1-ol, butane-1-ol, because the longest chain contains 4 carbon atoms. So 3-methyl-butane-1-ol is formed. Then you connect the OH to the second carbon, we get a 2-ol, then there is again 3-methyl-butane-2-ol. Now the speciality of 3-methyl-butane-2-ol, that is second structure, is that the second carbon is connected to an OH, a methyl, a hydrogen, then isopropyl groups. All these groups are different, so this compound is optically active. This carbon is called a chiral carbon, so that we have two isomers for this one, that is the enantiomers, 3-methyl-butane-2-ol. Now then you connect the OH to the third carbon, we get this one. You start numbering from this side because the smallest locating number can be obtained by numbering from the right hand side. 1, 2, 3, 4. On 2 carbon 2 there is a methyl and OH groups, so 2-methyl-butane-2-ol. Then lastly you connect the OH group to this carbon or this carbon, we get the same isomer, so CH2OH. Then numbering from this end, 1, 2, 3, 4, so there is a 2-methyl group. Then it is butane, the parent compound, so butane, then 1-ol, 2-methyl-butane-1-ol. So here, including the enantiomer of this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, then the enantiomer of this one, 5 isomers are possible. So previously you have seen that 4 isomers are possible when the carbon atoms are drawn, 5 carbons are drawn in a straight chain, 4 isomers, and here 5 isomers. So the total number of isomers now become 9. And then you draw 3 carbon atoms in a chain. Then the remaining 2 carbons can be connected here or here, both are the same, because when a mirror plane passes through this carbon, these two carbons become equivalent or similarly placed. But when you connect 2 carbons here or 2 carbons here, you get the previous isomer. When you connect 2 carbons this end in a straight chain or 2 carbons in a straight chain at this end, you get the first isomeric structure, that is that of normal pentane structure. So you can avoid these two carbons and connect the remaining 2 carbons on the middle carbon, you get this one. And it's a highly symmetric compound because there is a mirror plane passing through like this line, along this line, so that this methyl is the image of this one, this methyl is the image of this one. Now a mirror plane passing through this daughter line, then this middle becomes the middle of this one. Then emerald plane passing through these middle loops, this middle becomes the image of this middle. So all the middle loops are equivalent. This compound is called the neopentane. So that you replace any one of the hydrogen atom by an OH group, you get the same isomer. So you replace one hydrogen from the CH3 by an OH, you get CH2OH, and then you can replace DH here, you get the same isomer. You can replace DH here by OH, you get the same isomer. You can replace DH by OH, you get the same isomer. So numbering this carbon chain, the longest chain containing the OH group, 1, 2, 3, it is a propane derivative. It is propan 1-ol, then 2,2-dimethylpropan-1-ol, that is the compound. So that is enough, thank you. Now again, suppose we are considering the model of neopentane. Suppose we are considering the model of neopentane, giving different colors for the methyl groups. All these are methyl groups. The middle ball is carbon. So the yellow ball and this pale red, pale or rose red ball, and this green ball and the blue ball all represent the methyl group. Then a mirror plane. A mirror plane passing through this methyl, the carbon, and this methyl. You find this methyl and this methyl are images. That is, blue methyl and green methyl are images. Now you rotate this molecule, and again consider a mirror plane passing through this green methyl, yellow methyl, and this carbon. Now this pale rose methyl and the blue methyl are object and image structures, object and image groups. Then you rotate this molecule, then you consider a plane passing through this blue methyl and yellow methyl, the green methyl and pale rose ball, that is methyl, are image and object. Then you can rotate this molecule like this, and you consider the plane passing through the blue methyl and green methyl, the pale rose methyl and this yellow methyl are object and image groups. So the molecule as a whole is highly symmetrical, we say, so that all methyl groups are equivalent. So only one isomer is possible. So thank you, that is enough.